And the risk that the driver takes is just a fraction of a second will make a difference.
Well, I would hope that it's not a risk. I think that they have to understand their limits. They've been around this racetrack so many times so fast, and I think it's calculating that driver ahead of you. It's understanding how the track has changed. It's to me, these are changing over a 500-mile race. You'll have a lot of dynamics that they have to deal with, and it's a thinking man's race. And I would say Richard Petty won a lot of races, not because he was the fastest, because he was always thinking, and I think it's calculating. I'm not trying to hire the guy with the biggest right foot. I want to hire the one that has the best brain.
So you look at the three smartest racers, guys you could find, right?
I wouldn't trade them for anyone. And I think that the one thing that people don't realize is that there's only one going to win the race coming up at Indianapolis, in a few weeks. But the transparency, they sit in front of each other after every practice. They look at all the technology, all the tracings of what they've done on a particular lap and where I braked, what's the car doing. And we have all this telemetry, and they share it with each other. You know, it's almost like going to engineering school. So then they can see, what can I do better to get my car as fast as Elio or as fast as Will or Ryan's? And I think this is the great thing about the Penske Racing Indy team. We've had that for so many years, whether it was Bobby Unser or Al Unser or Mark Donahue. I mean, we said, look, it's one team. And remember, if the team wins, you win. And I think that's been our success.
Was Mark's death the biggest blow you ever had?
That was a huge blow for me because, he and I, started together. We drove the truck together. He was the young man from Brown University, the college degree and the crew haircuts. And I remember they laughed at us when we came to Indy because we cleaned the floor up in the shop. We had chrome wheel or polished wheels. And they said, they're the college boys with the crew haircuts. But, Mark was, he really was the bedrock of the start of our Penske racing team.
Do drivers have one common quality, those that you have seen that have been the best?
I think the ones that we try to hire, ones that know how to win. And I think that we have not hired a driver, and I think in our career as Penske Racing, where they haven't won in some series. I think first they have to understand how to win. They've got to have the technical expertise to communicate, with the engineering team, because today it's very technical. And I would say third, they got to communicate commercially because, with the sponsors today, it's important. Right. So this is a well-rounded individual. And I would say the business-to-business relationships, that we have with our major sponsors is so important. And to me, we ask them to do a lot off the track and on the track. But to me, they want to win and they're committed. This is not a place where you show up with your helmet on a Saturday. They're thinking racing 7 days a week. Yeah. And when they stop, it's probably the time they should get out. I remember when Rick Mears came to me after, winning Indy four times, and he said, Roger, I just don't have it in my belly anymore. These young guys are much better. It's time for me to retire. So that's what I want to see, from our drivers. When it's time, they know it.
Join us online at charlierose.com.